years now of the race recessions. I have a couple things I want to say. First of all, everyone, please, if you want, please come forward. Get involved. Be in the room. Okay, so this is we do this performance every year in January to kind of commemorate the anniversary of us having started the race recessions, which for those of you who don't know, happens here every Sunday night, 8 o'clock to 10. And we've been doing it every week for 7 years, which is pretty cool. In this little context of that, that's over 350 performances now that have been here on the stage. Not to mention that we record every single thing and put it up on our website so you can go back and listen to all the music that's happened here over that amount of time. We've also been able to, because of this, we've been able to host touring bands from all over the country and around the world who can come here and perform, make a little money, and be a part of this really awesome community. So tonight, the format is going to be alternating stages. So we're going to have a performance down here, and then a performance over in the back there, and then we're going to be going back and forth, so there's going to be actually very little time to be set. So once we're done here, make your way to the back room, and there'll be something happening up there. So just so you all know, we're also going to be collecting donations tonight, $5 to $15. And before I pass this around, I want to say a couple things about donating. About a year and a half ago, I wrote a grant proposal for something to help fund the racial sessions, which I ended up not getting, but I did some calculations for a budget that would realistically take place if we had done this without the resources that we already have. And it came out to, if we'd rented drums every night, and rented a bass amp, rented keyboards, and all that stuff, it came to be over $30,000 a year that we would have spent on equipment for just running this session. Not to mention that we record everything and put it up online, and people spend lots of hours. So there's a lot of hours and a lot of effort that goes into this session. So, when this comes around, please give generously, because all the money is going to go back to the musicians tonight, and there are a lot of them performing. So, one more thing. So, Cry and Roar is named Cry and Roar because there's a member of our community who passed away a few years ago, Andrew Perico, who described his sound as a saxophone player somewhere between a cry and a roar, and we found that to be very fitting for this particular festival. And I find it to be very fitting right now in our current world. For those of you who feel like you want to cry or roar, this weekend is the weekend to do it with friends, with community, with people who just want to collaborate. So thank you all for being here. Thank you to Cafe Racer for having us for so many years. Actually, how about a round of applause for Kevin?
Yeah! Wow!
So without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to Neil so he can talk a little bit about his ensemble here and his music.
Hi everybody. So this piece of music that we're going to play tonight is called Concepción Picciotto. And Concepción Picciotto was a peace activist who held a continuous round-the-clock peace vigil in front of the White House for 35 years. Concepción died on January 25th, 2016. So this is literally, we're literally almost 1 year now past her, her passing in Andrea. Again, in particular, where I think we can all feel that her mission of nuclear disarmament and her mission of peace and justice is a righteous one, and it's the right one.
Yeah.
And it's something that she worked literally her entire life for. She was homeless. She was also an immigrant. She moved here from Spain, and she took up Peace Vigil in 1981. This piece of music was written a little over 6 months ago for a performance at the Secret Forest show in the Winona Woods. And that's a performance that bassist John Teske is playing here tonight, and I put on every year. And at that performance, I was just inspired by just her, what I call just her love call. That's what I call it. And so walking around the Winona Woods, knowing we were going to do this performance, I was just deeply inspired by my surroundings, deeply inspired by the bird calls that I was hearing. And I'm not one to really anthropomorphize animals, except for maybe my cat, my good friend. But I was just so deeply struck by the beautiful bird calls in the woods, and so I started transcribing them, and worked with two musicians who are going to be our birds tonight, who are among you, so you're going to hear bird calls throughout the evening. And then scored for this amazing ensemble, and I introduce all the members of this group at the end of the piece. It's continuous, it's about 15 minutes long, and includes some graphic scores, which I created using materials I found in the forest, such as mud, what I smash on a piece of paper along with sticks, and little bits of pollen from flowers and all kinds of different things to create this graphic score, and I did little squiggles every time I heard a bird call. That's what we're looking at some of the time. So without further ado, this is my love call back to Concepcion Pichiocho.
love be. Let your love be regardless.
Thank you.
dry little sound as a bird's neck bones sifting into place to sing. Its eyes open and widen. Birds with bigger eyes sing first. Rackety every day to hear this every day forgets.
Step and the cards left you sprawling. Here is this way, and your hip bobbed. And there's blame of light too. When eyes are hummingbirds, who'll tie them with a lead string? But it's the tunes they want most, sending them skipping out of the treetops. Whistle then. Who'd stop the leaves swarming, curving down the east in their braided jackets? Well enough, but there's small comfort in naked branches when the heart's not yet seen the way.
Thank you. top.
Thank you.
decided not to include mention of the readings so as to give you a little another one to surprise you tonight. On oration was Jen Giller. Performed selections of people that poets that I've been reading quite a bit of lately: Ann Carson, William Carlos Williams, Pablo Neruda, and Jenna Douglas Peace Justice. So thank you to her. The birds that you heard: Jenna Martindale Webben and Sarah Pye. On violin, maybe we can hold our applause till the very end. Katie Bonatero, Andrew Seifel, John Teske,
Ebony Miranda,
got the last name, first name, last name. Ivan Arteaga, Levi Gillis, Katie Olson.
Knock it over.